rhoid data type, right? Yesterday we left with the rhoid data type, right? Except that we have completed everything. Am I right, guys?
Yes.
Yes.
Combining all data types we have discussed, right? Yeah. Combining all data types we have discussed, except the rhoid data type. Except rhoid data type. So now let us discuss about the rhoid data type. Rhoid data type. Rhoid is a pseudo column. Rhoid is a pseudo column. So we can discuss about the pseudo column later. Now, what this rhoid will do? Rhoid data type represent actual storage address of the row. So the each row in the database of a table identified by uniquely. It is easy to remove duplicate records from a table. So we will discuss this topic in subquery, how to remove the duplicate records. So by using rhoid, we can remove the duplicate records as well. So rhoid is a pseudo column. What is pseudo column? The column which is not appeared physically, but available physically in every table. Let's try to understand this one, guys. What is pseudo column? Pseudo column is the column which is not appeared physically. That means it cannot appear when you see in physically, but available physically in every table. Every table. How it is? You can see now. Select. I'm giving you an employee table. See in my data, select star from EMB. Okay. Can you see any rhoid column here? Any rhoid column? Rhoid means the column which is not appeared physically but available physically in every table. Can you see any rhoid column here? Can you see, guys, any rhoid column?
No.
But actually, the Oracle server, when you insert the data, automatically it will assign one address for the every row. The address is called as a, the address will get stored into the row ID. That means row for row, it's defining one ID. For row, it is defining one ID. That is called address. So what I said, the column which is not appeared physically, that means physically the column is not appearing, but available physically in every table. Let's see how it will. Row ID. Is it available physically? When you mention, then only it is showing. When you mention in select list, then only it is showing. So here it is not appearing physically, but available every table physically. Available in every table physically. So if you want to see the column, then you have to specify in select list. EMP star is indicating all columns of the EMP table. Here star is indicating all columns. So when I use row ID, I have to declare a table name dot star. We can discuss about this. No worries. Just see, observe that. The row ID is available physically in every table. So how it is assigned? The Oracle server, the SQL server. When you insert this data, automatically one row ID will get stored. So yesterday we inserted this one. See, for that also it has stored. Let us try to insert one more thing. Insert into EMB, EMP number, comma, E name, comma, shall values. So EMB number is 102 is Venkat, shall is 1000. Well said. Select star. Same again, you can return. See, 102. I have inserted ename as a year. See, this column is indicating this value. So these things you no need to worry. We can discuss in insert part. This time showing to understand. EMB number is indicates that 102. Ename is indicating that Venkat. Salary is indicating that 1000. See, 102, Venkat, and 1000. Did I enter any row ID? Did I inserted any row ID here? Did I insert it, guys?
No.
No, sir.
Then how it has inserted here? How it has created? See, here I inserted only three values.
Automatically it will.
Yes. Automatically, Oracle server create one address for the row. The address is called as a row ID. Address. Why it is create the address? When you use the row ID column. When you use the row ID column. So we will get in more detail about this row ID in subqueries and indexes. So when you use this one, so when you use this 102, this address is used by the indexes to retrieve the data very fastly. Without this row ID, first it will check this one. If you mention where 1002, it will check this row. Next it will check this row. Next, it will check this row. Like that, it has to check every row. Then, here condition is true, where EMB number equal to 1002. So then it has to return. It has to. Now, see, EMB number equal to 1002. My one row is came, right? How Oracle is searching for that? Like when you use row ID, when you use EMB number equal to 1002, so Oracle engine is searching for that. First it will check this row. So condition is false. Next it will check this row. Condition is false. What we mentioned, where EMB number equal to 1002. So how it will compare? First EMB number, what is that? 7369 equal to 1002. So condition is false. Again, next, what is the value, guys?
Seven four nine nine.
Equal to 1002. Condition is false. So this is also false. Next, how it will check? Next.
7521 equal to?
Yeah. 7521 equal to 1002. Why I am mentioning 7502 means where EMP number equal to 1002. In place of EMP number, then EMP values will get substituted. So here also condition false. So condition false, then condition false, then condition false, then condition false, then condition false. So every time condition false, where it will get true? It will get true 1002. So when condition equal to 1002 equal to 1002, condition equal true. So when condition equal to true, then Oracle compiler will go and give the buffer that this condition is true. Then you can return this value. This return all these row values. So now it's return the all these row values. So here how many checks has been done, guys? How many times the checks has been done? How we need to know? How many times the checks has been done? The condition, the Oracle compiler has to check, right, each time. How many times it has checked?
until it is not finding the right record.
Yeah, see, when how many rows you are having, when it will get true, that till that get true, true condition, then it has to check. For example, here MP number equal to 7900. Then who is 7900? James Clerk. So this details is came. So now how many times it will check? First year check. Condition false, 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 false. Then condition true. How many times, guys? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11th time it has true. So the Oracle compiler has to check 11 times. How it will check? 7369 equal to 7900 first row. Condition equal to false. Next 7499. Here second value is 7499. 7499 equal to 7900. Condition equal false. Like that, it has to check for each row. 7369 equal to 7900. Condition equal false. Then 7949 equal to 700. Like that. Condition false, false. So 11th time it has true. So the Oracle compiler will give the Oracle buffer. So I have condition is true. Where is that condition equal to? The 7900, then it's written this value. So again, it has to check next to these values. Again, false. That means how many rows on the column? That many rows, that many times the Oracle compiler has to check. How many rows we have? 15 rows. So 15 rows it will check. That means obviously it will take some time to check, right, for each row. But when we have row ID, the index if you created on this column, so the index, how it will perform? It will save the row ID, address of the row. So when you create an index on EMP column, then the index will save this address. Then when you use like this 7900 EMP number equals 7900, then it won't perform all checks. It won't perform each and every time check. Directly, it search with the row ID. So instead of searching all rows, instead of searching 15 rows, it will search with this row ID one time only. So to search, instead of searching with 15 rows, it search with directly this row. So that means obviously we'll get save some time, right? Am I right? Got it, guys?
But here, how it will know the value, the unique ID or the row ID for the 102 is this one?
You no need to identify this one. So no worries. We can discuss everything, this one, the index and subqueries, to understand the subject I am telling. So you no need to worry about this address. When you create the index will save this address. You won't save anything. So when you mention where EMP number equal to 1002, then it won't search with EMP number equal to 1002. It search with the index. Index, what is that? AAA equal to this one, JAAP. Then this one equal to this one, it will perform. This one equal to then that.
You got it.
That one. So that is the reason it will search only one time. So we can discuss in the index part later. That is, no need to worry. Just you need to know what is the row ID. What is the row ID, guys? Row ID is a pseudo column, the column which is not appeared physically but available physically in every table. So you have seen, right? Here, see, when you mention only EMP table, it is not coming. But even though table is having row ID, so here it is not appearing physically, right? So when you mention row ID, it is there in the available. That means the column which is not appeared physically but available physically in every table. So here, is there right available? Let's see for another table. Let's see another for table. Select row ID, comma dept dot star from dept table. See here also there. So if you just give the table without mention, see, is it available? Is it reflecting there? No. But table is having the row IDs. Table is having the row ID column, but it is not appearing physically until unless you mention in select list. So that means the table which is not appeared physically but available in every table physically, that is called pseudo column. Why pseudo column? How it will work? So the pseudo column, the row ID column, is represent the actual address of the row. So how it is representing? Which is the actual address for the row, right? So even we inserted one row, so by that time it has created automatically one row, right? Oracle server. So it represent the actual address of the row. I said, right, like in data plan, did you remember that one? See, here I said the data will store, as a sectors within the sectors in the blocks. So that means here if it is saving, let us take as here if it is saving this one, the row ID will save this address. The row ID save this address. Here this block is saving, right? The row ID save this address. Instead of searching all tables and going to the data, it will directly search with the address that we can discuss in index. How it will search. Clear, guys? Any doubts on the row ID data type? So the data type declaration is, so all data types we have declared like this only, right? Column name, then data type, then size. If you mean that one, this is the angular brackets. Not mandatory. For some data types, size is mandatory. That's the reason I mentioned both. ERC, blob and character not required any size. So how we will create the table? Create table name, then column name, then data type. So here column I employee ID. ID is a number data type. So I declared number data type. First name is a string data type. So I declared as varchar2. Last name is varchar2. So this is also string. Next, gender. Gender is string data type. But I said, right, when to use varchar2, when to use char, the requirement in our, I think, day before yesterday class. So here only I'm inserting one fixed length data type. That is only female, one byte. Male or female. So by default, if you won't declare for character, it will take one byte, right? So I mentioned just char. Then blob, photo, to insert in any unstructured binary data, photo, videos, and some large objects, graphics, audio files. So we have to use the blob, binary large objects. Anyone is having any doubts on the row ID column? Anyone is having any doubts, guys? Did you understand, guys?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. So one Akash is asking one question. That, see, Akash, you can speak up. That's not worry. That is good question. So what he is telling, that if you have, for example, create table name is I am creating the one. So why I mention the row ID is used to remove the duplicate records. So we can discuss in subqueries. So why I mention this one now? And one more statement I have added. The row ID is identifying the unique queue, identifying the every row as a unique queue, identifying the row ID is in a database, identifying the every row in a unique queue. Here, for example, student number data type, I mentioned as 20. Next, name is, so S name, just giving the varchar to. Table is created. Let us insert the data. Insert into these things, you no need to worry. Insert these things, now it will come like where we can discuss here, sub language. So statements or categories, we can discuss everything. We can discuss create, alter, then insertion, everything. You no need to worry about that. Okay. So table, insert into stud, insert into table name stud1. The values, cell number 10 I am giving. Name is Sam Akash. Sorry, values I have to miss. See, one row inserted. Now again I am inserting some duplicate row as a again so inserted. Now again inserting the 20 as Winky. Again I'm inserting the 20 as some Srini. Again inserting the 20 as some Priya. Okay, so now check the data. Select star from stud1. See, we have duplicate rows, right? We have duplicate rows. So SL number is the having the duplicate and S name is having the some duplicate. Now the question of the Akash is, if there is duplicate record, then it will have different row ID or same row ID. So what I said, the Oracle server, it won't consider the duplicate values. So when you insert any row, by default it will assign one sequential number of row ID. Let us see. stu1 dot star from here, two columns only. No, let me put two columns then. Cell number, S name from stud1. Here 10 I have inserted. Whether the row ID is same, guys, you can observe only last this one. This is everything is the sequential number of row ID. So here A for 10. Here also, is there A or is it a different? Is that A or different?
Different.
So even though if the duplicate record, the Oracle server is assigning unique queue row ID. Am I right, guys? All right. Even though if you are inserting the duplicate row, Oracle server is assigning the unique queue row ID. See here, 20. Is it same, guys? These three are the 20. Is it same, guys?
Is it different?
No.
No, right? So, row ID, what it will do, each row in the database, not only this, but our tables also. Here, you have one row ID. Here, Here you have one row ID. Select other row IDs for the other table, not this one. See, is it same, guys? Is it same? Different table, right? Is check any row ID is repeated for any other table?
No.
See, you can check here also. See, here it will change. 7OAAE, 7NAEE. So here 8WAAE. So that means it won't repeat. That means each row in a database, not a table. So what row ID will do? Each row in a database of a table. Why we use the row ID is each row in a database of a table, for every table, identified by uniquely by using row ID. Got it, guys? Each row in a database of a table identified by uniquely. That means every row ID is having the unique key in a database for every table. So by using row ID. If the table can have same name and again. So here if I create EMP 10, again 10 and Akash. Insert, for example. Row is inserted, right? For EMP table. Year 1, there is that. Year 10 Akash is there. Okay. Here also 10 Akash is there. Here you can observe this row ID. Then here you can observe this row ID. Again, or else select to observe. I will put here only. See, here, sorry. Here 10 Akash is there, here 10 Akash is there. You can check the row ID now. Is the same row ID, guys? You can observe this one and this one. This one. Is it same row ID, guys?
No.
So that means whether the data is the same, or else is the same table, or else is the different table, that's not a matter for Oracle server. When you insert any row, any single row or single value into our database, that will identified by one uniqueue row for the database. That is called this statement. So each row in the database of a table identified by uniquely. So that's the reason I mentioned it is used to remove the duplicate records from a table. So here, while removing, we can mention that this row ID is a different. So how we will compare? We will compare with the row IDs. So we can discuss that one in the subqueries part. See, Akash, here. Akash, are you clear?
So here I'm having one question.
Yeah, tell me.
So here, as we are having duplicate rows, duplicate record having the different rows ID. So when we read those, select star from employee ID 10, that will give two records, correct?
It will give. See here.
It will give, so two records.
Wait. See here. here is the right, just to mention,
select serial number equal to,
select S number comma S name from EMP, sorry, from STUD1.
Where
you no need to worry these things, guys. You no need to worry about these queries. We can discuss each and everything. We'll spoon feed you how to write also. Okay. Where SL number equal to T. How many records it will come, guys?
Two.
Sorry, this is spelling mistake. Yes, name. See how many rows?
Two.
So where and all it will match. So I said, right, first it will check this one. First, condition true. Then it will go to the compiler and saying that this condition is true. Then the value will get stored in the SQL buffer. Again, it will come here. The condition is true. Again, it will go to the buffer and it read the data there. So that means it paste the data there. Yeah, one more, this one is. Next condition fall, then condition. Then last it will give the message to the SQL buffer. Yeah, I have done the search. Then SQL buffer having how many rows now? Two rows. When SQL compiler go and paste the data there, then it will return the data to user who is reading the data. So we are reading the data, then we get the data. Clear, guys? Anyone is having any doubt in the row ID part? If not, we can go for the SQL introduction. Okay, fine, thank you. Next, introduction of SQL. So the agenda is, what is SQL? User request flow. So this is what is SQL, why SQL does both are the same only. Then SQL syntax, SQL statements. So before going to the know about the SQL. So you wanted to know some of the things like why this is SQL. So nowadays there are a lot of programming languages in the world, such as Java, JavaScript, Python, C, CPP, PHP, and so many more. Snowflake, Tableau, everything. There are so many. Tableau is a tool, not so this one. Many programming languages are there. .NET, everything. So, but one of the easiest programming languages is SQL. One of the easiest languages is SQL. How it will be easy? That is like a simple thing, like it is everything like as a English commands. So here, English language. You mean to say select is select. Where means where. From means from. So if you know the some basic English language, basic English words, if you know, then it will be very easy. So one of the easy programming languages is SQL. When it will be easy means you should practice on daily basis. Okay, SQL is not just easy to learn. But it also one of the widely used program in the world. So in world, this program is using more and more. So one of the widely using program language in the world. So SQL is not just used by software developers, but also many other people also use. The quality and all analyst people, then business analyst, then data engineers, then data scientist. So many more people will use. So SQL is not only used for the SQL developers, I mean software developers. Many other people also use. Those all are called, many people are there. I just made four. One is quality, business, data engineers, and data scientists, and so on, many more. What is SQL? Can someone tell me, guys?
SQL stands for Structured Query Language.
Yeah, good.
It is one of the programming languages.
SQL stands for Structured Query Language. Why it is means structured. The data which is going to the store in the database, it is a form of some, it is a maintaining one structure. It is a maintaining one structure. So what is our database? Our database is a relational database management system. Relational database management system. So in relational database management system, so it, the SQL is going, the database is data is going to stored in a some structure format. That is the reason we can call a structure. What is query? Query in the sense you can read, you can by using the queries, you can read the data from the database. How it, we can read? We read the data means here by using SQL. We can store the data into the database as well. Storing how we are doing by using insert. Okay, by using SQL, we by using queries we can store read the data from the database. And we can store the data from the database. So that is the query language in the means you know that like so that is the reason SQL stands for structured query language. Okay, and also we can refer in earlier days. Previously, the when they are introduced in earlier days, they used to refer as a SQL. We can call it as also SQL. So later on, it's become as a SQL. So some people still call it as a SQL as well. Okay, so what is SQL? It's a programming language. It is used to interact with relational database. So why we use this SQL? It is used to, it is a programming language and which is used to interact with the relational database. So using SQL commands, you can read the data from a relational database. Here I am reading the data. Reading the data means which is already stored the data from data in database. I am reading the data. I am reading this data. It means I am retrieving the data or reading the data, both are same. Okay. So by using SQL commands, what is command? This is select is one command. Select is one command. So using SQL commands, you can read or retrieve the data from the database. Or you can write data into the database. Write in the means storing. You can write data in the same. So what is the command you are using for this? Insert. So this is also one command. So what I mean to say, using commands, either insert or SQL, except these commands, except this DDL, DML, DCL, TCL, and DQL or DURL. These commands, you cannot write a single statement in our SQL. Statement is nothing but this is one statement. This is one statement. So we use some create table, right? That is also one statement. So yeah, without using these commands, you can't write a single statement in our SQL. Using a SQL statement, you can read the data, retrieve the data, you can store the data, or you can write the data into the relational database. Relational database. Okay. So you can also create, modify, and delete database. So I have shown you right in introduction. Now we can create the database. Here we have created one table and inserting the data. That is called create the database. And modify means if I want to update here 10 means 100, then we can update by using SQL command. Okay, update emp set. You no need these things. We will discuss in SQL statements. You just observe what I am saying. Whatever I need to show you as a practical. If any word is coming from me, where emp number equal to. EMP set, update EMP set, update EMP set, EMP number equal to 10, sorry, EMP number equal to 100. We are doing 100, right? Where EMP number equal to 10. So two rows updated. Why it has written two rows, guys, when you use the update here? Why two rows is updated, guys? Can I get any answer from anyone?
There are two rows.
Two rows. Yes. Number 10. Yes, very good. See, what I am doing, update is a command, SQL command. So, EMP table, set EMP number equal to 100. So, I am setting that EMP number is equal to 100. Where means where. So, EMP number equal to 10. EMP number equal to 10. Wherever EMP number 10, that it has to set to that 100. So, here 10 is how many rows? Two rows. That's the reason two rows updated. Let us check the data. See, 10 become 100. So that means you can, by using SQL statements, commands, here the update command we are using. There are multiple commands. So in relational database, you can create and modify and update the database. Here we have updated, here we have created and stored the database, and we have read the also. Okay, SQL can also be used to analyze and protect the data. So we can analyze the data, how the data is storing, like what and all data is storing. So where I need to improve my firm, my business. So by seeing the data only, they can analyze, right? So now there are multiple tools, Power BI, Tableau, QuickView, Talend. There are some other tools to visualize the business. So how they will do? They will fetch this data from the database. Then they will create one dashboards and they will give it to the users. So if you are working for any business project, like if you take Reliance Trends, there are multiple, right? Like kids wear, men's wear, women's wear. So the user wanted to know, the Ambani Reliance person, he wanted to know in which location for which category that is doing, the business is doing well, and which is in poor in business. So they used to maintain one database. The data, the Tableau people, they will fetch the data from the database by using joins or subqueries, anything. So they will fetch and they will create one dashboards for everything, one separate. Women's wear separate, and the trend analysis, how it is performing, and kids wear separate, and men's wear separate. By seeing that, they can understand. They will do like this, cost per SQL. See, cost to revenue like this, so that they will understand. Okay. almost all relational database are available today. Like almost all relational database, which is are available in today, such as Oracle, MySQL, and MS SQL Server, PostgreSQL, IBM DB2, SQLite, MariaDB, and Teradata, and Hive, and many more are there. These all are relational database. So whatever the relational database available in our market, so those all relational databases uses SQL only to manage their data, whether storing the data or interact with the database, everything. So all these are relational database management systems which are available in the market. Those all are uses the SQL only to manage their data. So different RB relational database managements have created their own versions of SQL. So the majority of functionality, for example, MS SQL Server, that is Microsoft product. Oracle is Oracle product. Postgres is IBM DB2 is IBM product. Like that, Postgres SQL is Postgres. So there are different companies which have developed their own relational database management system, the relational database. So they have created their own versions of the SQL, and majority of the functionality and syntaxes are common across all the relational databases for all technologies. So that means no matter which RDBMS you are uses in your real time, either PostgreSQL or Oracle, MariaDB, MS SQL, MS Server, IBM DB2, SQLite, TSQL, Teradata, Hive, and so on, many things are there, right? No matter which database you are working. So if you learn this SQL, it will be applicable to all, because all of the relational databases, this MS SQL, all of the relational databases across all databases, so they have created their own versions, right? The all majority of the functionalities, either 95% all functionalities are same, but the products are different, because one company has created their own product. So no matter what, this if you learn this SQL, it will be applicable for all. Okay, before we get into the commands, it is important to understand that SQL is a primarily used in RDBMS. That means, so before going to this commands, before going to the SQL commands, what we will discuss. So you wanted to understand that. So that most common usual language for the RDBMS is SQL. So you know, right? Relational database management store the multiple tables, that each table can have set of columns and rows. See here, 17 rows. If you go for another table, there are 5 rows, and another table, 2 columns and many rows. Like that, in each relational database management systems, store the data multiple tables. The tables, how it is storing? It is a set of columns and rows. So the different tables will be related to each and other. That means RDBMS, whatever the table you are going to store, thus all tables related to interrelation will be there, right? See here, DBT number. So that if I take select star from DBT, here DBT number, here DBT. This is having one relation. Now select star from shall grade. See here, salary column is there. Here low salary, high salary is there. How we can assume the grades? Like we have the grades in our education also, right? Before some below 60, it will come the 60, 70, 70, 70, 80 marks, 8 points, 80 to 9 is 9 points, 9 to 100 means 10 points, like that. The same way, 700 to 1200 is grade 1. So 1200 to 1400 is grade 2, like that. So we can, here the salary column is there. So we can define the grades for the employees. This table is having also one relation. Got it? So whatever the data which is going to store in the database, relational database, those all columns are related is one to one or one to another. Some table, they will direct to another table. That is called RDBMS, right? So any doubts, guys? Clear? Anyway, I have written again this one, but the background of that I wanted to clear you. That's what I explained. No matter which database you are using, it will be applicable for all. Any doubts, guys? Do you want me to clarify?
No, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thanks for the confirmation. Okay. So SQL stands for, I said already, structure query language. What is structure? What is query? Also explained. So it is designed for managing data in relational database management system. So I said, right, SQL is used to interact with the relational database management system. How we can interact, whether we are reading the data or whether we can store the data. Okay. So it is pronounced as previously SQL. Sometimes they is called as SQL also. That is also a covered. So SQL is a database language. It is used to create, delete, and fetching the rows and modifying the rows. So I showed you, right? How to fetch, how to delete, how to create the data, and how to modify. Modify in the sense updating. So this one also I covered. It is a programming language. It is used to interact with the relational database, and it is used to store the data and delete the data and read or retrieve the data and modify the data. So it is common language for all backend technologies. That is called MySQL, Oracle, MS SQL, Sybase, PostgreSQL, SQL Server, Teradata, DB2, Hive, everything. So it is easy to learn. Then it is similar to English language. So I covered this all the things, right? While explaining about the introduction. So how user interact with the database? How user is interact with the database? So who is end user? Now I am the end user for this database, which is having. So I said, right, already, what is end user? When we discussed about the client server architecture, here I clearly explained. Who is end user? Whoever is having the access to the database, when they are trying to interact with the database. So and the request will go and retrieve, give the data to them. So those all are called the end users. Who are the end users for the State Bank, guys? We discussed on project, right, when first day class. Who are the end users for the State Bank?
Customer. Account holder.
Yes, customer. That means whoever is having the account holding the account in the bank for SBI, those all are the end users for the State Bank. Why? Because they will come and they whatever they need, so they will fulfill with the SBI employees, then they will go. That means they are coming with one request, and they are fulfilling the request, then they are going. Ultimately, the employees is providing service for the users only, no? So not only for this, for any bank, for any institute. So you people are the end users for my training, because you are interacting with me and you are gaining alerts from them. Then you are, what is your request here? You
think you are not audible.
Sorry, guys. Don't know this. This power is daily. It is going at around 9 only daily. So I wanted to look into some other option. So daily power down is again power is going and coming. So it is disturbing us. I will look into option, some other option. So we will continue. Yes, sorry for that. From tomorrow onwards, I will take care of that. Okay. Can you hear me, guys?
Yes.
So sorry for my. You people are the ears for my training, because what is your request? What is your request? You wanted to learn the SQL. Okay. Here I am. Sorry, network is fluctuating. Please answer, guys. Hello.
Yes. You're audible.
Clear, right? Are
it's breaking. It's
voice
breaking.
Breaking. Voice
yeah,
breaking.
Voice is breaking.
Yes, your voice is breaking.
Yeah, still breaking.
Now, is it fine?
Nah, okay. Now it is okay.
Is it now?
It's breaking somewhere.
Then you can, guys, so that I can change my network. Okay. As you know, that's being a bank with the individuals, whoever having the let us take us our training. So I am the database is
your voice is breaking.
You are the end user.
Yes.
What is speaking?
Yes, your voice is breaking somewhere in the middle.
Yeah, let me change my network. Yeah, now you can tell me, guys. Hope it will be fine now. I've changed my network.
Yeah, okay, fine now.
Hope it's fine now. Okay, see. Now, I am the database. Trainer is the database. So, who are the end users? You people are the end users. How? You people are coming up with one request that I need to learn the SQL. So here, who is DB? Trainer is DB. You people are the end user. So what is your request? What is your request, guys, to learn the SQL? So what is query tool means? What is the in between us? Zoom. So via Zoom. So via Zoom, you came with the request and learning the, you wanted to learn the SQL. That request is to learn the SQL, and to Zoom, you are interacting with me. And whatever your interaction to learn the SQL through Zoom, again, I am providing you. got into my point here. See, you are the, you people are end users. Your request is you need to learn the SQL. So coming up with the Zoom, and you people are sending your request. For example, if you are asking one question, where you are asking, you are the end user. You are asking one question, and through Zoom only we are interacting, right? Through Zoom only we are interacting. So here query tool is for us is Zoom. So where you are asking one request through Zoom, it is coming to me. Through Zoom, it is coming to me. So based on your question, again I am answering. So that answer is coming through Zoom, then come to you. So here, who is the end user? Who is asked the question? That guy is end user. Clear, guys? Clear.
Yeah, okay.
Whoever made the request for the question or something, those all are called as a users, and the query will come to me through Zoom only we are interacting, right? So your query tool is Zoom, then the query is coming to me, I am the database, then I am sending through Zoom only, I am replying the answer for that, then answer is coming to you through Zoom again. So you are the end user for this. Okay, so now it's the same way. If you want to interact with our database, so there are some query tools. So you need to see, now I am making one request for the database. That is that we wanted to check the what and all EMP table is having the data. So here I am writing my request. How I am placing the request to the database by using query tools. What is the tool? SQL star plus. The SQL plus I am using here. SQL plus. I made my request to the database. Then database has written the data. I made my request to the database through SQL plus to the database. Then database has given result to me, that saying that there are 17 rows and this is the rows. What was happening in background? So I made my statement. I made my request through query tools. What is the tool? SQL plus. Then the request went to the database. Then database has given to the data to the query tool. Then I have received the data. So like that, there are many tools for us: SQL developer, Toad, PL SQL developer, SQL navigation, and SQL plus. So these all are called environmental tools. So in our real time, we use 99% this tool only, SQL developer. 99% who is SQL developer. There are some cases while you are deploying the development code into the production, by the time we use, there may be a chance for use 1% to the SQL plus. Remaining 99% we use SQL developer only. 99% we use SQL developer only. SQL developer. There are other tools also, Toad, PL, SQL navigation, SQL developer. Some rare cases, some of the projects are using Toad, very less. Okay. So by using these tools, I am loading the data. Loading the data means I am creating a table and inserting the data. Then I am retrieving the data. Retrieving in the sense, I am fetching the data from the database here by using query tools. Loading the data means I am inserting the data, right? This is the loading the data. Okay. Then I am modifying the data. Modifying the data means what is that, guys? What is modifying the data?
update.
What is meant by modifying the data, guys?
Updating the data.
Yes. So I am updating the data. Next, deleting the data from the database. Who we need to delete? Example.
You delete command.
See, what is the table? 10 we have, right? EMP table. See, now EMP table is having 100. I wanted to delete 100. So what I will do by using delete command, delete from, no need to worry about these commands. We can discuss again where EMP number equal to 100. See, two rows deleted because 100 is having two rows. So let's execute the table. See now, previously 17 rows and now 15 rows. So the ACAS has been received here, 100 has been deleted. So by using these tools, our SQL, we can load the data, we can retrieve the data, we can modify the data, and we can delete the data. These are all called manipulation. Manipulation. So we can do the manipulation with the database. So the database is having collection of object. So what and all objects we have? Table, index, sorry, table view, and synonym, sequence. These all are called as a database object. We can discuss one by one. Next, what does SQL? This all are we discussed. With SQL, we can query our database in several ways using SQL-like statements. With SQL, we already discussed these things. With SQL, a user can access data from relational database. I am the user, right, for the database. Who and all users for the database, guys? This one also we discussed. Who and all users for the database? Can I get an answer from anyone? Who and all users for the database?
Developer.
Who and all users for the bank?
Account holder.
Account holder. So who and all is having access to the database? Those all are called the users. So I am the one user for the database. So with SQL, users can access and relational database management system. So it allows user to describe the data. So like this, user to describe the data. Say anything like fetching the data, MP. So here describing the data. Okay. It allows user to define the data in the database and manipulate. Define in the sense, create a table and insert the data. I mean, storing the data. And manipulate when it is needed. Whenever we need, we can manipulate the data. So we can manipulate. What is manipulation? Manipulation is nothing but loading
create,
the data.
Update, delete.
Yeah, delete, update, delete, retrieve, load. These all are called manipulation. Okay. Whenever we need, we can do it. So it allows user to create and drop database tables. Database and tables. Now we have created one table is select star from UD one. So now I don't want that table. By using drop command, drop table to UD. The table is dropped. So try to retrieve the data again here. Table or view does not exist because we dropped the table here. So that's mean to say this one. It allows, SQL is allows the user create. We only created this table. And we only load the data. So we only updated the data. And we only able to do the drop also. So now I have dropped. No need to worry about these commands. We can discuss one command each. It allows to user create view stored processor functions. This is the PLSQL concept where we can create the stored procedures and functions. We can create view in the SQL. So when we will discuss in the SQL, like when views concept is came, then we can discuss the in views concept, then we can discuss how to create the view. See here. See, views in Oracle. We can discuss this all topics. Okay. Next, it allows to user set permissions, tables, and procedures. That means, so I already discussed, right? When we create the table, that is related to your schema only. So I will explain you about the schema in next session. So no others is users. For example, database is having 10 users. Whoever is having the access, those all are the users for the database, right? So I have created user one created one table. So user one created one table. The table is belongs to user one only. So remaining 9 users, they can't access until unless user can provide the permissions for that. That is called with SQL. User can allow user allows to set permissions on tables, procedures, and views. Got it, guys? Any doubts? So I'm going some speed about this because this one and this one we already discussed. In starting itself, I have given some introduction, right? These all are called same only. Any doubts, guys? I'm happy to answer. Okay, let's go. Next is SQL syntax. It follows some unique set of rules and guidelines called syntax. So every product when you develop, so you have some set of rules how we have created. Now we have used delete from EMP and where commission equal where EMP number equal to 100. So now I wanted to select star from EMP. So now I wanted to delete these two rows. So delete from EMP where EMP number equal to 1001. So one row deleted because there is only one row about the 1001. If it is 10 row with 1001, then all 10 rows will delete. Okay. So this is called syntax. So this is called one syntax to retry. For example, now I'm using syntax is wrong. Delete from, not delete FRM. EMP where EMP number equal to 1002. Let's try to delete this one. See, table or view does not exist. Here, what is the problem? FRM I mentioned. So this is syntax wrong. So you must use the syntax like this only. To retrieve the data, you must use the syntax like this only. Select from EMP. Missing expression. What is expression in the sense is the column is missing here. Star is indicating here. So how you need to read? Either you need to mention the star or you need to mention the set of columns. Like which columns you need to retrieve. This one we can discuss in select statement. We can discuss in the type of statement. Okay. Name EMP number from EMP. Either you need to give like this or you need to give star. Star is representing all columns. Here, if you want only two columns also. So that means you should follow this syntax. Then only Oracle understand or SQL understand. That is called some set of rules, unique set of rules. So here also. Create the table, what we have followed, guys, you must follow this one. How many columns you need to declare, that's your wish. But syntax is create table. Table name, then open parenthesis, column, data type. Column, data type. See, this is the syntax. Create table, table name, open parenthesis, column name, then data type, then size. Column name to data type, size, and so on, multiple columns. So you must to follow this syntax. Then only table will get create. then only table will get created. Okay, so those all are called some set of rules. So SQL follow the syntax is following some syntaxes, some rules. Based on that rules only you have to follow. That means the all syntaxes you need to be remember. So those all are called set of rules and guidelines. Those all are called as a syntax. Next, SQL is not case sensitive. Generally, SQL keywords are written in uppercase. So here, not case sensitive means, here while I am reading the data, I mentioned as all capital letter. Now you can mention same. Same data is coming, right? If you mention smaller case also. That's the reason it is a not case sensitive. Okay, you can perform most of the actions in database with the SQL. So whatever you want, you can do it our SQL statements. You can do it in our database by using SQL statements. So what are the SQL statements? So SQL statements are started with SQL commands. This is one statement. 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 So SQL statements are started with SQL commands. What are the commands? Insert is one command here. Here is a select one command. Here is a update is one command. So whatever, if you want to write any statements, that must be start with the SQL command only. So without SQL commands, we cannot write a single statement in our SQL. Okay. Those all are called commands or keywords. We can call it as a keywords as well. Here, what are the commands or keywords? Select, insert, update, delete, alter, drop. Without this, create also is there. Without this, we cannot write a single statement, and like this and so on. And statements ends with the semicolon. The statement must be with the semicolon, right? Then only Oracle understand that, so that the statement has been ended. See, you can observe everything for every
Hello.
Statement. Yes, please.
I have a question. So, yes. Is there any SQL command like truncate?
Yes, we do have.
So I don't know how does it function, but is it similar like delete command?
See, there is a most important question in interview. What is the difference between delete and truncate? We can discuss that one in the very deeply. So that is very, very important question for every interview. Delete and truncate. So we can discuss there. The functionality wise, that is not at all similar. So you may think that is similar. See, now here, drop is 1001. So what happened? 1001 case is alone is dropped, right? Here, one row is deleted. Delete from EMP number, where EMP number equal to 1001. That means one row only deleted. So you can delete one row or multiple rows or all rows by using delete command, some set of rows. So you need to specify the which row I have to delete. This is the syntax. But whereas truncate is when you use the truncate, all rows will get deleted at a time. You can't get it back these things. So for example, here, delete from EMP, where EMP number equal 7788. Number record 7788. There is no 7788. Okay. For example, select star from QD1. This one also we drop, right? Okay, no worries. So the difference is these delete some delete is used to delete some rows or set of rows from a table. Truncate is used to delete all rows, including the table space. We can deeply discuss there, okay? If you want now itself, you can connect me offline. We can discuss.
Sure, sure. Thank you.
There are some set of rules we can discuss deeply. Okay?
Okay.
So yeah. This is the introduction is completed for the SQL. So there are the some types of SQL statements, or we can call it as types of SQL commands. We can call it as sublanguages also. Statements, SQL commands, these all are called sublanguages in our SQL. So without these commands, you cannot write a single statements. Okay? So we can discuss this part very deeply from tomorrow. So for every command, it will take one day for at least one session for one commands. DDL commands alone, I think alter only will take many like a longer session. There are some set of rules while you are doing the alter option you have to follow. So I think this DDL will take 1.5 day, I mean 1.5 session, or mostly one session, more than one session. So I'm ready to, guys. I'm ready to answer your question. Anyone is having any questions? Guys? You don't feel like today most of the thought is some theoretical way, because you wanted to, you should know before going to the data while you are reading, you should understand all these things. That's the reason I explained. You should not come and ask after some days, what is the syntax? Okay. So tomorrow onwards, it will be fully practical. Then you should be, today also we'll discuss some of the practical onwards. Like tomorrow onwards, it will be end to end is the practical. Without dealing with the database, we cannot work on it. DDL, DML, all those things. Any doubts, guys? I'm ready to answer your questions. No questions. Is anyone? No one is having any questions, guys?
No question.
Yeah, thank you. So I'm ready. See, if you are asked to ask any questions on the session, don't feel bad. So when you speak up, if it is wrong or it is right. So if it is wrong, if it is right, then it's well and good. If it is wrong, then when I correct you, then that will be saved in your mind forever. So I have done their mistake that Venkat has clarified me. This is what. So without speaking, you can't get it. Either it is wrong or it is right. That's no matter. So you have to speak up. If it is wrong or right, I will correct it so that it will be remembered for you. Okay. And some people, they may like state to ask questions. So if you are like that person, you can connect me offline, either WhatsApp or call to my mobile number. So I am available always, and available. I can help you on that. Like we will discuss on the offline. Okay. So this is. So if you have still any queries about the training or about the class, so this is my WhatsApp number, or else this is my personal number. So you can call me anytime, or you can. WhatsApp me anything. You can ping me anything. Anyone joining newly in this session, guys, today? All are older guys only. Anyone joining newly today?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. My name is good name, please.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, Kiran Kumar.
Yeah,
actually it is.
Is it your first class?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. My it is first class.
Yeah, Srinivas, you just stop the recording.
Yeah, okay.
You can stop the recording now.
Okay.
It is unrelevant. Only question.